Heavy metal has accumulated a substantial amount of subgenres since first being originated by Black Sabbath in the early 70s. And in this quick overview, for beginners on metal subgenres, we're going to give you a solid understanding of some of the most popular metal subgenres. So let's just get started. Our first question should be and will be this: what came before Black Sabbath? This is what we call proto-metal. It's not exactly a genre more than it is a way of describing bands and artists before heavy metal. These range from the hard rock scene to the psychedelia era of rock like Jimi Hendrix, Blue Cheer, Cream, and many others. Bands like Led Zeppelin, Deep Purple, The Who, and The Kinks are considered heavy for their time. Even guys like Chuck Berry, Little Richard, and Dick Dale are considered proto-metal due to their rebelliousness and their musical prowess. Black Sabbath's first album really set the foundation in 1970, and thanks to Master of Reality, the band set in stone what metal is all about, securing the formula forever. Master of Reality didn't have any jazzy-sounding songs, and the guitar tone on Tony Iommi's axe became a staple for future generations. The many albums of Black Sabbath helped to pioneer many heavy metal subgenres, and the band expanded their sound in its many eras thanks to the extremely talented roster of singers, like Ronnie James Dio, Ian Gillan, Tommy Martin, and even Rob Halford from Judas Priest. The new wave of British heavy metal drew from the 70s mainstream and underground styles of music. The intensity of punk rock produced fast and aggressive songs. Deep Purple had disbanded and Black Sabbath was consumed, to say the least, and it got even worse when Ozzy was fired in 1979. But the newly formed bands saw Motorhead, Judas Priest, and Thin Lizzy all as influential bands. Other groups also like Diamond Head, Venom, and Raven all remained underground while Iron Maiden and Saxon saw great success. Once introduced by Metallica's Kill 'Em All, but inspired by Motorhead and the new wave of British heavy metal, thrash metal rose into the scene in the early to mid 80s. Characterized by its aggression and fast tempos, Lars Ulrich notes Motorhead's drummer, Philip Taylor, aka Filthy Animal, as a source of inspiration for its aggression. Thrash metal introduced the extreme factor in metal, straying away from hard rock and leading to a new era. Bands like Slayer, Megadeth, Anthrax, Exodus, Death Angel, and some others followed on its wide acceptance. Moving on to death metal, and this subgenre is all about extreme growling vocals, complex guitar riffs, and lyrics often focusing on dark and morbid themes. The genre has grown into many other subgenres and lots of other fusion genres, but death metal's most prolific bands are Death, Cannibal Corpse, Obituary, Morbid Angel, and Possessed. While there are more, obviously, these bands pioneered the genre, pushing it forwards for more degenerative heaviness. The influences of death metal are found in Slayer, Celtic Frost, Venom, and Creator. The rather melodic and symphonic sound of power metal is undeniable. With soaring vocals, epic storytelling, and intricate guitar work, bands such as Helloween and Blind Guardian uplifted the fantasy-inspired atmosphere into heavy metal. A real big influence of power metal traces back to Ronnie James Dio and Iron Maiden. Dio wrote several songs for Rainbow like Stargazer and A Light in the Black, where he focused on medieval, renaissance, folk, and science fiction type themes. The album Keeper of the Seven Keys by Helloween is like a textbook for modern power metal. Modern power metal bands worth checking out are Camelot, Seventh Wonder, Rhapsody, Stratovarius, Dynasty, and Sabaton. Black metal is the sound of nothingness and chaos combined. Originating in Norway and pioneered by bands like Mayhem and Emperor, black metal introduces a brutal and raw approach to heavy metal, with raspy vocals and lyrics often exploring themes of anti-Christianity. For some artists, black metal represents a way into expressing their satanic ideologies and cultures. Black metal is divided into several branches such as Greek, Finnish, and Norwegian, whom all emerged around the same time, but now there's also Scandinavian black metal. Song structures are far from being conventional, offering a rather refreshing lack of clarity between the verses and the chorus. Check out Bathory, Rotting Christ, Blasphemy, and Immortal. Progressive metal aims to push the boundaries of complexity and creativity, combining elements of various genres like jazz and classical music. Bands like Dream Theater and Tool are known for their intricate composition and lengthy songs. Progressive metal found an early home in thrash metal with the release of Rust in Peace by Megadeth and also the album And Justice for All by Metallica. Eclecticism is one of the many qualities that this subgenre offers in between riffs, choruses, and solos. Some of the bands you should really check out are Planet X, The Faceless, Between the Buried and Me, Animals as Leaders, and Michael Romeo. There are so many heavy metal subgenres, and each one supports a relatively unique idea and way of thinking. Each subgenre has its own identity and characteristics. You can be found headbanging to traditional heavy metal or diving into the darkness of black metal. Consider subscribing if you like this video and leave a comment below, letting us know what your favorite subgenre of metal is. Thank you so much for watching, and remember everybody, stay metal.